fans, and welcome to tonight's game between the Elon Phoenix and the Indiana Hoosiers. Number 23 is the player who deserves our attention in this contest tonight.
He's got great offensive skills, and to go with it, some solid defense.
The Hoosiers will undoubtedly feed off his play in this contest. The Hoosiers are the highly favored team in this one, Dick. Still, what are the keys for the game?
Well, the keys should be simple tonight, Brad. Number one, I look for the point guard to be in control of the team out there. He's got to be the leader. He's got to be the boss. He's got to be in command. Second, reward your big man for working hard down low. Get him the ball, baby. If he has position, get the rock to him immediately. Lastly, win the battle on the glass. That's going to be huge tonight. Boy, that stat at the end could be a big one.
I think you're dead on, Mr. Vitale. Let's see what happens. Let's get this one started. Leans in. He puts it in with contact and all. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. Rothman picks up the foul. First personal foul. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block.
Oh, right there, they missed him inside. You got to get the ball when a guy is open. That's a special art, feeding the post.
Now the high screen. In the paint, and he'll kick it back outside. On the dribble, gives it up.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
Applying pressure. He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up. You get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
Dickie's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
They work it around the perimeter. Hobbs is eager and excited to compete.
Well, you know, Brad, these student athletes play with fire and emotion. You rarely see that in the pros.
To pack it inside. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
Gave it up. The shooting guard gets the ball. Goes up for two.
He keeps his dribble long enough to run his guy off the screen and slide in for the nice deuce.
The Phoenix have a mismatch in the post.
They need to get him the ball there.
He fires away. There was no doubt about that one. Had a momentary look from three-point land with the fake. Tries for two.
I tell you, terrific shot. Really impossible to get a piece of that baby. Sucker out of the game, man.
For two, he drains the shot. Inside, too physical. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
High post flashes for the opportunity. With a bucket, doesn't go. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
That is a dagger in the heart, that shot, Dick.
Hey, they lost focus here. They need a timeout to regroup, Brad.
Executes the baby hook.
I tell you, didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position. And then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking a shot when you make that turn.
Hey,
They strip him in a basketball. Got a little too fancy. Too much mustard there, baby.
This is college basketball at its best, Dick.
Oh, I couldn't agree with you more, Mr. Nestler. We are so lucky that we get to go to all these schools and experience the mayhem firsthand.
And the ball goes out of bounds. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
The offense gaining great post position down low.
Absolutely. Getting a good inside angle, a poor job defensively, no help. I mean, that is post play at its best.
On the dribble, gives it up, tries for two. Indiana are on a nice little run at the moment, partner.
They have to remember solid defense leads to good offense, which is what we're seeing right now.
Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nestler. We got a good one going. Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He fires it up. He gets it to fall. There's a double team waiting there. Inside. And one too many dribbles and a steal. Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. Turns it over. Shows patience, waiting for the reset. Gave it up. The small forward gets the pass. Controlling the ball. He's got an open look for the shot. For two. Can't get the shot to drop. Both teams looking to get things going here. He was applying great pressure defense. Went for the steal, but he wound up with a personal foul instead.
Hey, defenders must be confident. They're going for a steal. If not, it'll often end up with a personal foul.
He keeps the dribble as they reset. Now they work it around the perimeter. He shoots from the baseline. They can't stop this guy, Dick.
Want to give him a try, Brad?
If only my knees weren't aching. He'll regroup the offense.
He'll take some pride on the defensive end.
Rothman, slowly performance has just gotten in his head.
Things aren't coming easy for him right now. He's in a rut.
Gant comes up with it. And the fans are going wild.
You're right. The student sections, the bands, and the crowd are always urging their team to victory, like a sixth man.
Fed the low block. Playing for the steal in the post, and he didn't get it.
I'll tell you, tried to make the spectacular play, but now he's embarrassed.
The power forward with the ball.
Coach looks on. Focus, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
He takes the shot. Off the rim and no good. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. The power forward takes the pass. Sinks the shot. Looking for a good shot.
The frustration right there.
They are red hot right now.
They're feeling it from everybody on the floor, Brad. They're getting it from every spot on the court. Great anticipation defensively.
The point guard takes the feed.
That was a great, great effort right there, trying to play that passing lane, anticipating really well.
Here's the three ball. He drains the bucket. Dick, at defense looks tired.
Hey, that's no excuse. They've got to dig down deep and get the job done.
Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help some.
He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up and get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
On the dribble, gives it up, fake.
Tempo of the game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
They work the perimeter. With a bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket. Roll that replay ready, boys.
Here's a double team. With a great block.
They just keep shutting the door.
He's good for another score.
Hands in his face. Anytime now, boys.
He fouled him. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Guys, he seemed very focused from the beginning. His game face was on, and he understands it's his time to perform. Let's send it back over to you.
Tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me? Hey, Brad, you want to get to the line early and often. You end up getting your opponents into foul trouble, and it's also an opportunity to get some points.
Makes his second shot.
There's the trip.
Blocked! Nice job defensively. When you're one of the top-ranked teams, you've got to bring your best every night. Teams are always looking to knock you off.
Hey, when you have a squad like this, Brad, you always have to bring your A game. Opponents will come after you with grit and boldness.
Gave it up.
There's the screen up on top. We got to see that one again.
For contact. Drops the bucket despite the harm.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
The lane. Both teams looking to get things going here. On the outside.
He didn't have the good angle. They should have got it to him about a second earlier.
Gets it back out. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And he made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
The dribble, gives it up, picked out of the air. Looking for a good shot. Entry pass in the paint.
Pressure that basketball, help one another, communicate.
And now he's got a little something for the crowd. They're not going to like this. They're going to be offended.
Man, the players are feeling it, and they want everyone to know that they're feeling it.
The free throw line. He hits his first. Second one is no good. Strong rebound.
Getting that quick outlet pass is so important for the fast break.
Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter.
Nice job to create the angle using the glass.
Oh. Gave it up.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
He looks at the hoop. For two. Perfectly executed. Working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
Nice move with a face up.
I'll tell you one thing, Brad, I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
On the dribble, gives it up. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works. Great job of freeing himself with the screen, but shot won't go.
This whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so's the defense, and they do a nice job. Way off target. Tries to turn, and the defense comes up with a put.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move. Look at that spacing.
There they come with a double team to stop it. Ten seconds left on the shot clock. He shoots from the top of the key. Off the rim and no good. He intercepts it. He fakes the shot.
Pushing that basketball. What a great steal. Defensive player was really right on top of that basketball.
They are heating up this building where they're shooting right now, Dick.
The hits just keep coming, baby.
Reverses the ball after having a guy in the post. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. The student body and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
The post flashes up high if he wants it.
I sometimes wonder what it would be like to be a skywalker, elevating and throwing it down, Mr. Nestler. How much fun would that be?
On the floor and up and under.
I did a great job of the ball fake that created the up and under move. And good footwork. It's essential with an up and under move to utilize good footwork.
That's just great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I tell you what, they telegraphed that pass and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Job defensively. They just won't give many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Picked off. Tries for two. Gets it to go. He'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
They work it around the perimeter. He looks for the bomb. Great shot.
We didn't see that again, Brad.
He shoots from the top of the key. It's good. There's a double team waiting there. Stolen ball.
Nice high post screen.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart. Double team now. Bad angle.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up and get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
Boy, it's so important when you're getting points off turnovers. And look at that stat.
I tell you one thing, coaches go nuts. If that stat's negative, it absolutely makes you lose the air and you get balled like I am. Great defensive play. Anticipated well. When you're an anticipator, you got a chance to do well. A lot of guys, they're reactors. If you're a reactor, you're one step behind the action.
Spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot. Dump it inside.
Gave it up on the inside. For two, Elon are on a bit of a run.
Let's see how long they can keep it on, Brad.
Strip, Red. On the dribble, gives it up. He goes with a baby hook. Can't get the shot to drop. Intercepted. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Takes the pass in the paint. Dick, it's really been a while since I've seen a team shoot like this.
Hey, every once in a while, you'll get a squad that gets on a tear and simply makes your jaw drop. It's fun to watch, isn't it, Brad?
Steals a pass. Shot clock is dead. They're working around the arc. Hard foul. Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
For the bucket, and in and out. He puts up the J. He can't miss.
Hey, this young man's feeling it, Brad.
At halftime, the Hoosiers are ahead by five. Best play of that half. Let's take another look. Indiana is getting a lot of rebounds, Dick, in that first half.
Hey, Brad, these boys gave a monstrous performance on the board. They were relentless in retrieving the rock.
Our focus player update, Dick Vitale's going into the second half. What does he need to do, you think?
I think they ought to set some screens for him, a little double screens. He's a great shooter, but he's not getting the opportunity. I think his teammates have to screen for him.
Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I tell you, really, a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he does it exceptionally well.
move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
In the paint. Pass down low. There's a drop step. And, oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spin.
Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
How can you not love this game and the hoopla and fanfare that goes along with it?
The Rutgers fans are going nuts. They're going bananas, Brad.
Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
Stolen away. Turnover. Great job knocking the ball loose, then chasing it down. The Phoenix are trailing by six.
Ooh, look at a shot block. They got some contact. Nice hops.
Gave it up. The fake. Here he is defensively, and this is going to be an Academy Award, Dick.
Absolutely, Academy Award at its best.
Another turnover.
We're not talking apple turnovers either.
I tell you, nothing like having those legs, man, where you bounce right off the floor.
Down on the low block.
See, first initially he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. A good rebound position, a good block out. And that's essential in the post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately a block out and get good rebound position.
Entry pass in the paint. And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Brad, some of the players told me before the game they felt their biggest key was to get the ball inside. They said, we have the personnel to score in the paint, and that's what makes us a big threat.
Thanks, Erin.
I'll tell you one thing, you better be able to establish post play because that gives you inside-outside action.
There they are on the low block, on the move inside, and the big guy picks up the foul.
Hey, Brad, you can't allow a guy to get the ball in that deep, and he does a great job putting it to the deck and attacking the basket.
His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
Perfectly executed. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And he made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Pass down low. There's a drop step. And, oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
Tries to turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
He can't get the bucket to fall. On the dribble, gives it up. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
For two, in and out. On the outside, the defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal him off.
Trying to stay with him defensively. Down he goes.
Oh, what an acting job. There's no doubt in my mind he's flopping, baby.
Jumps in. Basket falls despite the contact.
defender is still applying great blow pressure, Brad.
Drains it. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Nice move with a face-up.
I tell you one thing, Brown. I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
He takes a three. 10 on the shot clock. The Hoosiers are up by 7. Had him in the post and didn't pass it in. Reverses it. On the inside.
Nice fake.
Good fake. There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. He shoots from downtown. Dick, they are loving it behind that line.
Hey, as long as you're hitting, the loving is good, baby.
Fakes it. He attempts a jump hook.
I tell you, didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position, and then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking a shot when you make that turn.
Gave it up. Jumped in front to take it away. He shoots from right of the circle. Way off target. The students are all fired up and ready to do whatever's necessary to help their team win.
The student body looks like they're ready to terrorize the opposition.
Let's take a second look.
Inside.
He shoots from right of the circle.
Hey, let me tell you, he earned that trifecta. He earned it. Give him a hug. He earned that, baby.
Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle, Dick.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
Takes away the pass. Working it around the perimeter. From left of the circle. He might be on his way to a career game, partner.
Well, he will, Brad, if they don't get somebody on him in a hurry.
Looking for a good shot. He's got some room. He wants a three. You betcha. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
On the dribble, gives it up. Lets it fly. Perfectly designed, perfectly executed, easy basket. Dick, he really seems to be getting great position down there in the low block.
Yeah, he really is gaining possession because he gets the good angle, and they also have the good angle.
Rejects it. And he tries to spin away from the defender.
I tell you, he's versatile in the post. He's got the spin move and a number of other activities.
The student body appears to be pumped up, and they are ready to explode.
They look like they're having a blast.
That's a 7-zip run.
Two and off the mark. From right of the circle, misses from downtown. Basket and the harm for the senior.
He's got a big time harm, baby.
They're feeling good. The momentum is on their side and everything is falling into place. Their body language, Dick, says it all.
Hey, can you blame them, Brad? They're playing well.
The Hoosiers will step to the line for the first time. He got it.
That's a 10-0 run.
Let's get back to the action. The Hoosiers seemingly have a solid number of seniors in their lineup, Dick.
Hey, Brad, you know I love seniors. At a time they're in their fourth year of eligibility, they are solid and reliable basketball players.
He shows the sweet touch. Picks off the lazy pass. Gave it up. For the bucket. Can't get the shot to go. Looking for a good shot.
Gotta think right now. Gotta focus defensively. There he is. Strips the ball loose.
They'll work it around the arc. He shoots from left of the circle. The Hoosiers have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He bombs from outside. Tickles a twine. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
For that reason right there, that's why I love college basketball.
Hey, pandemonium is in full effect.
On the dribble, gives it up. Gets the ball and now faces his man down in the low block.
Oh, very aggressive player once he got up in the face-up position in the post.
Up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Guys, this is not the start he wanted tonight. He is his team's marquee performer, and his slow start could be a recipe for disaster. We'll have to see how his teammates respond to all this, and we'll continue to monitor it from the sidelines. Brad?
Thanks, Aaron.
I got a great job of the ball fake that created the up and under move. And good footwork. It's essential with an up and under move to utilize good footwork.
Takes it off him. Outside. Pass down the guy in the post to go the other way. From right at the circle, off the rim and no good. Moving it around the perimeter. He shoots from outside. He makes the shot.
That's seven unanswered.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I'm telling you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job of post position and spreading his body and getting the ball.
Picks off the pass. Gave it up. He shoots from the top of the key. Way off target. Here's a double team. Robs him of the ball.
Dump it inside.
Look at these fans. They're loving it.
It's electrifying in here.
They work the perimeter. Prohop draws the foul. Nice move. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
With the freebie. No rebounding that. Misses the second shot. And they're catching nothing but iron at the free throw line, Dick.
They're going to catch more than that from their coach if they don't start putting them down, Brad.
They work it around the perimeter. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper.
That was a great, great effort right there. Trying to play that passing lane. Anticipated really well.
He launches the bomb. He's money with the shot.
Up and inside.
They'll work it around the arc.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
It's stolen. Number three goes for the aggressive steal from the tightly guarded position.
Not only is he applying ball pressure, but looking for the aggressive steal as well.
From three-point land. Ain't no stopping them right now from the arc, Dick.
You better believe it, baby. They're making them pay from out there.
He takes the shot off the baseline. Off the rim and no good. Makes it. In the paint. The ball goes out of play. Well, Dick, what's the front court production looking like to you?
Well, you know, Brad, your bigs really can influence how your teams play. Rebound, blocking shots, opening shots are all very important skills which your big players should possess.
Picked off. Trying to draw the foul. Lawson makes the finger roll. Dick, when I see those types of things, I just get chills.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
On the dribble, gives it up. He looks for three. Scorches the net.
If you watch it again, it's even better!
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Picked out of the air. That's one of the best parts of college basketball, the student section. They're fired up and they're ready to try to help their team.
You can't forget about them. The witty humor and dedication to their teams. You can't find this in any other team sport.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Looking for the foul, and he scores despite the hack. Looking for a good shot. Gave it up.
Great defensive play. Anticipated well. When you're an anticipator, you got a chance to do well. A lot of guys, they're reactors. If you're a reactor, you're one step behind the action. Look at that that spacing.
It's stolen.
Very soft defensively, no pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Off the mark, but he got the dunk and the foul.
He went through that lane on a mission, Brad. My goodness, Brad, what a play.
That was a great play, Dick. I agree with you. He shouldn't let his emotions get the best of him, though. He better watch out. He'll get one. Got it from the free throw line.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He attempts the three, sinks the shot. Strips the ball. That's a foul. Talk about a great drive. How about the State Farm drive of the game?
I tell you, he was explosive. He was up and away. What a drive to the rack, baby. That was special.
They work the perimeter. Puts it up, looking for contact. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Jump hook from the low post. He gets another shot off and in.
Hey, this show's about to start, Brad.
That's why I love this game, Dick, for that reason alone.
Wow, listen to those fans. The crowd is thunderous.
On the inside. The ball goes out of bounds. Nick, look at the number of points off turnovers.
I tell you, getting baskets off turnovers is such a great and easy way to score, Brad. You want to maximize these opportunities as much as you can.
Shot clock is dead. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a punch.
That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
Our focus player update, our final one of the ball game, and he led his team to victory.
Well, I'll tell you, 9 out of 10 times, if the focus player plays well, you're going to get to the winner's circle.
Indiana wins with a gaping margin of victory tonight.
The outcome was never in doubt. It was always a question of how dominant they would be.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.